Saturday Morning Science is about crystallization, growing crystals, and what we're going to do is grow crystals while confined in a 2D in a 2D plane from these water films that we've been investigating previously. Only this time, we're using sodium chloride solution from the galley that we use to put on our food to grow the salt crystals with. And the sodium chloride solution that we have in the galley is close to a saturated solution. So once we draw one of these films, it doesn't take much evaporation before the crystals start to grow. So there we have the film, and look to the side will show that it's significantly thinner than the wire. And the first order, it looks about half the thickness of the wire, which puts it about 350 microns thick. And here, sometime later, about 3 or 4 hours later, start to see little seed crystals growing around the edge of the wire loop, and we'll see later on that this is caused partly from a nucleation site at the wire, and partly from the surface tension dynamics. And here's some time lapse over about a 12-hour period showing the growth of these crystals. And that was so cool. We're going to see this a second time. Same time lapse. And you can see these crystals are forming. Some of the crystals are hexagonal, and some of the crystals are square in cross section. Here are crystals close up to ones currently growing in a film. And you can see there are square crystals and there are hexagonal shaped crystals. Both of those are consistent with a cubic crystal system, depending on which orientation the seed started to grow. And you can see diagonal lines in the square-shaped crystals, and these lines are not voids, but they're actually filled with sodium chloride that is very transparent. Now here's a demonstration to show that the crystals seem to congregate around the edge. When I pop on them and force them away from the edge, they go right back to the edge. And this is due to some really interesting surface tension forces involved, and we'll see later on where those come about. But the side of the film is slightly curved due to its attachment to the wire, and the crystals distort the surface of the film. And here you can see a reflection from the surface of the film, and you can see how the crystals are distorting the surface of the film. And the combination of the distortion of the film surface by the crystal and the curvature of the film as it approaches the wire makes forces that cause the crystals to go next to the wire. Here's a scene where if you look at the wire, you can see little crystals spalling off from the wire, and then sometime later you'll see another crystal spalling off right in the same location. So you can see that there are active sites within the wire which instigate nucleation of the crystals, and then they will move away and another crystal seed will form at that site at the wire. And again, this is taken over about a 10-hour period. And you can pick and choose. You see a good seed crystal that you want to pull out, you just go ahead and pull him out and leave the rest, and then you can start a second crystallizer film and plant that seed crystal in and have that seed crystal grow to a much larger size. And all of this is just standard crystallization technique that you can do on the ground or in space, but the uniqueness here is that we have this two-dimensional thin film, and we're growing crystals in the absence of the kinetics that typically occurs in three dimensions. And these crystals do have some finite thickness, so they're not a two-dimensional body. They do build up some thickness, thick enough so you can pick them out of the film. But the dynamics associated with them growing is more on the 2D level than the 3D level.